I'm not doing. This is to protect me. So if he goes to bite, he bites the rabbit, not me. It's my barrier.
Okay.
And he's never been challenged. Dogs normally don't get challenged when they're, you know, angry, barking, and biting. So I'm going to take up his real estate.
Okay.
Instead of most people back up,
yeah,
which gives the dog,
yeah,
more power.
Yeah.
I ain't going to do that.
Okay.
So he may whittle a little bit or even poop because his nerves, that energy doesn't know what to do because he's being confronted.
Makes sense.
Okay.
I'm going to do the screen. I'm going to do the screen so I can hear you. Let's see the screen here.
Tail between the legs?
Yeah.
And that's fear. You got that closed up?
Yep.
No, you don't.
Oh, wow. You want me to take that, the tennis racket?
Yeah, take the tennis racket. I don't need that anymore. Okay. Hey. Shh. He needs to learn that just because the door's open doesn't mean he gets to come inside.
Yeah.
Rules, boundaries, and limitations. Huh? Notice I walked him back further that time. I want respect.
Do you want this one instead, Dave?
Hold on just a second, Kath. I'm working. What? Are you guys giving him a lot of affection?
What's that?
Are you giving him a lot of affection?
Yes.
Stop immediately.
Right.
That's where the insecurity's coming from and the anxiety.
Really? From the affection that we give her?
When a dog doesn't have to earn it, why should he have anything to do with it? Hey! And dogs learn by association, so I make a sound, then I make the correction. Most humans know how to make a correction, but then I follow through on the correction. Perfect. Hesitation before he came in. Too many muscles down there. There we go.
There's this one.
Okay, now this one's better. This one's too thick for him.
Okay.
Is it better to use that or harnessed with that?
No, harnessed after training.
Okay.
She has a choker too.
I see this.
Well, right. I have a choker for her as well.
Oh, you don't see it.
That's just a leash.
Okay. Oh, okay. I thought that was a choker.
No, it's a choker.
Yeah, see, that's kind of sick.
No.
Hey! Let me do a little correction.
This is her choker right here, Reed.
Perfect. Let's put that on. You guys don't have it as bad as it was explained on the phone.
She's not as bad, that bad as you thought?
No. No, I've dealt with vicious. I mean, I'm just, these are all puncture wounds from a boxer or a stitch type. I get bit seriously about once a year really bad.
Really?
Yeah.
It's just, when she goes out and sees anybody, it's like a growl and then her gets there and it's terrifying.
And she can't be around other dogs. The biggest thing is she'll jet as soon as we open the door, try to block it and everything, she just jets. She'll come in, she'll just pee all over everything.
Yeah, that's out of nervousness. She hasn't been socialized as a pup. So when a dog doesn't know what to do.
We got her when she was a baby. She's only 6 weeks old.
She wasn't socialized in that 6 weeks then.
Yeah.
Now the correction you want to do is you never want to pull up. And you never want to pull back on a leash. That drives the dog forward. So I'm going to bring her back to me. There we go. She's to the side. Mm-hmm. That throws the dog off balance.
To the side?
Yeah. Because dogs can only do one thing at one time. So if this dog is trying to get over you for its security blanket, because you guys are all lovey-dovey, right?
Yeah.
Come save me. When I do the correction, it gets the mind off you and back on me. And it's a quick snap. You never do it with a tight leash.
Okay.
Okay.
So the choker, this is the best for training. Is the choker this setup?
Yeah, always.
Okay.
Especially if you have a dog with fear, because you never know when they're going to snap out.
Yeah.
And it's the only way to stop the dog from biting another dog, a child, human, or me.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, these type of collars here, They can bite me all day.
Okay.
There we go. Now I'm just waiting for the dog to go in a calmer state of mind. Fight on the recall, so what I'm going to do is just hold tension. As he pulls back, it's going to get tighter because he's doing it. Mm-hmm. I'm not pulling forward. But he's going to find out as he moves forward, mm-hmm. it gets loose. And then he understands, oh, this is what I want him to do. There we go. Lick is love mm-hmm. and respect.
Are you crying?
I get it a lot. I get a lot of humans crying when they find out they actually can have a dog.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, same. Exactly.
Right. But don't let the dog know you're crying.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, you weak suck.
Like, she's great with the little ones and their friends because she knows them. She'll play in the garage with them, snuggle with them, but we can't take her out of the house and we.
To have neighbors run from you and like, and go back in their apartments, and it's like, you know,
constant cleanup, pee, and she's destroyed all our patios. We had
this one here.
Yes.
Yeah,
she shows up everything.
We had like a nice wood patio, everything there. She destroyed it.
Okay, now the other dog is an issue between these two, right?
We haven't really. I mean, he's a big lover and just like playful. But the second she gets in that, like...
Don't reach the other one up and bring her up.
Okay.
Hey. See, the dog's learning now that I'm the master.
Yeah, it is awesome. I'm gonna stay with that.
Give it a little thump on the side. Don't hold by the collar. See, this one just wants to make this turn.
Yeah.
But because of the intensity between the two, it goes into a
red. Exactly, yeah.
Hey! Try and hold that one, Stuart.
Chance.
That dog's way too excited.
It's okay.
Oh, that's what he's done. He's calm and
well. Yeah, what I want you to do is come over here.
Chance.
And just hold this one here.
Chance.
Does she pee when this stuff happens like this?
All the time. She pees after we take her out, bring her back in. Like anything.
Slow down the energy.
Guys, I'm serious. Change.
Give me my cup. Good little thump to a soul.
Just walk it.
There we go. Okay, up. I want him to calm down.
Mm-hmm.
There we go. You see that submission?
Yeah.
And
not?
That, all I'm doing, if you've ever seen a pack of dogs,
not either.
And one or two dogs don't like the energy of another
okay.
dog, those dogs are going to a full run. Shoulder blast that one dog. Dog's not hurt, but it goes rolling.
Yeah.
And yiping like it just got killed and ran over by a car. So I'm doing the same thing, but without the teeth.
Gotcha. Yeah, I know he's sitting down.
There we go.
They're not neutered either. Huh? Or fixed or neutered or spayed or...
Because he had parvo and stuff. They gave his chip and his shots and deworm for one more week.
But... Hey. See, now all I have to do is touch him. Now, I see this one more common than this one in the meeting.
That never happens.
Huh?
That never happens. She's usually like foaming at the mouth.
Yeah. Well, this one I've already got control over. This one I'm just starting on. See how the dog sits on it all? Without me going, sit. And I got the full direction.
Yeah.
Don't touch, don't rub. You see what happens is you never want to touch a dog unless it's in a calm state of mind. I mean, it's so calm in her life because you're reinforcing calmness with affection. Most people, when they have an excitable dog, you start, oh, what are you doing? What's going on? Well, you just, I'm telling the dog, this is the way I want you to be to get this affection from me.
That makes sense.
Yeah. That's why my number one most important rule, 10 minutes before you leave the house and 10 minutes after you get home, you ignore the dogs. That way, when you leave the house, you don't leave the dog in an excited state of mind to chew, because they have all that energy and they don't know what to do with it, because you just did a long goodbye.
Yeah.
And when you get home, you want them to respect your space, so that they're not jumping on you. Mm-hmm. And hold on to that one, tight.
She's never wired her tail and be happy.
What's that?
She's never wired her tail and be happy around him.
She's starting to relax. Yeah. Well, what it is they're putting trust in me.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of dogs trust their owners,
mm-hmm.
but they don't respect them.
Gotcha.
See, I've got trust and respect.
Yeah.
Now you see the nose being used?
Mm-hmm.
That's what we want.
Smelling.
Oh yeah.
The other dog.
That's curiosity now.
Yeah, not eyes. Brain.
Eyes and ears, nothing but aggression. Now, go on with that one tight.
Okay.
Some